Welcome to the Geek Homeworld. I am your host, Savage Tech Man. We talk sci-fi, TV, movies, superheroes, and all from a geek perspective. You can find us on Blogger, Google Plus, Twitter, Facebook. We're everywhere. Join the Geek Homeworld. Hello, this is Ed, aka Savage Tech Man, and welcome to another wonderful, exciting episode of the Geek Homeworld podcast. This podcast, we're talking about passion through podcasting. And I'm going to talk about why I chose the podcast, why I think you should podcast, and maybe give you a few ideas and point you in the right direction if you don't already know how to podcast. So we're just going to jump right in here. But before I jump right in, I would like to say thank you to all of the listeners we've had here at Geek Homeworld. We are international. We have a very big following around the world and in the U.S. And I want to thank every single listener. If I could, I'd shake your hand. So this will be my virtual handshake. But thank you for listening, for taking your time out each week and just checking out what we have to say here at Geek Homeworld. You can also check out our blog on Blogspot, and we've got some other ways you can interact. Obviously, follow us on Twitter at Geek Homeworld. So we're talking about passion through podcasting, and I'm going to start with why I chose to podcast. I think I podcast because mainly I feel that I have important things that I just have to get out. If you know me, I'm a talker. I have opinions, strong opinions at times on different things, but I have different views about different topics. And here at the podcast, we focus on the geeky things like movies, TVs, action and adventure, and superheroes and stuff like that. So I've got a lot of differing opinions, and they're not always what you think would be mainstream, you know, and I love different opinions from, you know, what I have. And so it makes for a very interesting thing. I have a passion, and that's one of the words I'm going to probably use a lot during this part of the podcast. And I'm going to talk about having a passion for things, loving what you do. I have a passion for broadcasting, and podcasting allows me to get my message across to a global audience. My entering the world of podcasting was really an extension of what me and my friends would just sit around and do any given day. We'd go see a movie and we'd talk about it. You know, we see Avengers, whatever was out. We watch a lot of movies and then we'd just go and talk about it. And now I get to do that a lot with my wife, and it's wonderful. And she has different opinions from a female geek's point of view, which is awesome. My entering the world of podcasting also, not just being an extension of talking to my friends, but I learn things too. We talk about tech, and I learn from other people. I learn by listening to other people that are in the field. There are giants in this field, some A-level, like level 5 mutants, if you know what I mean, those real famous ones. And then there's some that are, you know, second tier and third tier and all that, and I'm not going to tell you what tier I fall into, because honestly, it doesn't matter. It does not matter. It's what your passion is and whatever your level is. And we're going to talk a little bit later about what you define as successful, okay? But we're talking about why I chose to podcast here. And I always wanted to work in radio from a very young age. I would listen to my 45s, my tapes. I'd make mixtapes. I'd call in the radio station all the time and win things. And I would listen to American Top 40. And I could tell you probably to the day the positions of certain songs back then. And, you know, I grew up listening to local DJs that made it exciting on a Friday or Saturday to listen to the radio. And when you get that fire in you from a young age, it's kind of hard to shake it. So even though I haven't had the opportunity to be formally educated in broadcasting, I don't hold any degrees here on Earth. I listened and I learned from others in the field, and I still do that every day. I like to say that a day doesn't go by that I don't learn something or relearn something or find a better way to do it or a way that works better for me. And you as a future podcaster or a current podcaster will certainly know what I'm talking about, especially if you're podcasting now. You could probably look back 6 months, a year, 2 years back, and you can say, wow, I've really seen the growth in not just my sound quality, but the way I do my podcast. You know, whether you're doing audio, you're doing video, you're, you know, there's different elements of it, but you can see the growth. And listening to some of the peers, listening to other people's podcasts, having, as I have had guests on the show here, you learn different things. You learn different perspectives and different styles, and you learn eventually what works for you. And honestly, what doesn't, because no two podcasters are going to sound the same. We're all going to have differing opinions or similar opinions, but a different way of delivery. My love for broadcasting and podcasting really comes out of my natural gift of writing and expressing myself. Like I said, I love to talk and I love to debate things too. And I like to think that I can look at, generally speaking, two sides of an issue and try to be as fair as possible. And I hope I succeed at that. Sometimes maybe I don't, but I do try my best. I love the diversity of opinions and different types of people. Back in the day, talking about writing, I used to host a poetry group, and I've a published poet, which I know has not much really to do with podcasting, but it was where some of this came from. You know, my love for radio became a love for music, which I still have, that's carried me through my life and still does, that morphed into when computers got up and running and going in the mid-90s, Windows 95, 98. I categorized all my poetry and entered a few poems and got published, which was awesome. And I blogged a lot. And then around 2008, around there, is when I, just around that time, I discovered podcasting. I started with the Digital Man Cave podcast that ran from 2008. And we ran about 6 years. And then we've been doing the Geek Homeworld podcast here and blog and all that. So I've learned how to do what I do, but do it better and do it more to the point. And I can listen to earlier episodes of my other podcast, and I've done several different ones, totally different types of podcasts. And I imagine I'll do more in different ways and different formats in the future. So, you know, the sky is definitely the limit on that. But definitely being able to being a writer and being someone who's expressive definitely helps. I like to say, and I think this is original, but it may not be, so forgive me if someone said this before, but I podcast, therefore I am. And that's saying that my passion for podcasting has grown over time. And I have, through hard work and persistence, become a better podcaster. It's one thing to plan it, to know what you're going to say, then what you actually say that you record. But then there's the whole post-production side. Some people look at the front side of it and don't realize the hard work that goes in once the microphone is turned off. So that's kind of why I chose to podcast. Why should you podcast? First off, you should have a passion for the craft of podcasting. You need to find that one little area that you're totally passionate about. Like if you're a sci-fi fan, you're a Star Trek fan, or you're a Star Wars fan, or a Marvel fan, or a DC or a fan, that you take it down to that level. And the more you can kind of pinpoint focus on what you're expertise is in that area, then you just follow through with it, and you build upon it, build upon it, build upon it. Before you know, you will be an expert, or what is called an expert. There's a lot of people that get paid to be called experts that necessarily aren't experts, but you know what? Everybody starts somewhere, and you've got to find your little area, your one little thing that you're really good at, and focus on that. It's that pinpoint precision that's really going to move you forward and make you successful. And with time and experience, you'll find your unique voice, how you come across, how you podcast, your ways of doing, the shortcuts that you'll find in podcasting that work for you that may not work for somebody else. another reason that you should be podcasting is that you want to interact with people around the world. This isn't just a city, state, county thing. This is a worldwide phenomenon of podcasting. It's been going on for a while. And welcome to the fun, because it's awesome. But you want to interact with these people, and you want to have that as a human. And to any non-humans out there, I'm just assuming, I'm generalizing that you feel the same way if you're a podcaster. But you want to connect with other people. And especially about whatever you're talking about in your podcast, you want to interact with people, whether it's movies, TV shows, video games, or the actual how-tos of the art of podcasting. You will focus on one of those elements or a couple of those elements and do what you do, but do it well. And how do you measure success? That's another thing. Some people think it's just all about the money, and sometimes, like the song used to say, it's all about the Benjamins, but honestly, when you create art, when you create a craft, if your focus is totally money, and that's the singular focus, then that's not true to the art. Now, people will disagree with me on that. I'm not saying that you should not be compensated for the art that you create, whether it's music, it's poetry, it's writing books, it's, you know, ebooks, whatever you do, podcasting, broadcasting, etc., etc. Yes, you should be compensated. But you have to have good, original, quality information that you're putting out there that's unique. You know, even if you're podcasting about podcasting, you have to know what you're talking about. You have to put that forth. But if you're in it just for the money, then that's probably what you'll get out of it. But the people that find a hobby, because podcasting can be a hobby if you're an amateur, and there's nothing wrong with that. There is nothing wrong with that. You can podcast and never make a penny, and guess what? You're still a success. But you could podcast and it could become a career. There are giants in this industry of podcasting, or internet broadcasting as sometimes it's called, that do this for a living, that travel the world, that go to conferences and get to speak on panels. And if that's what you want to work towards, then more power to you. But if you just want to talk about Star Wars, and you want to, and there's a million Star Wars podcasts on iTunes and everywhere else on the internet, but you want to talk about Star Wars in your opinion, then go for it. Do it. And do it well. And for, like I said, the select few, but it's growing every day, of giants in the industry, they get syndicated. You have people that you turn on radio stations and hear them as their podcast on there. And there's a lot of I'm not going to do any name dropping. I can tell you I've got a few that I listen to and I've learned a lot from, but I've learned a lot of things on my own, my inquisitive nature, the how-to. I always want to know how things work. So that's always helped me as an inner drive to find out why and how you do something. And that's what's important. But the world can be your oyster, or, you know, it can be whatever you want it to be. You're only limited by what you put forth, the effort. So that leads to maybe the next question. How do you get started in podcasting? Well, first, you ought to make a plan. You ought to sit down and make a plan. And everybody has their own workflow. You'll find out in your workflow what works better for you. What somebody says may work for you may not work for you. But you may pick and choose, and you'll see. You'll find your own path, your own destiny. You'll follow your own path. Use the force. But put your plans together. Decide where you are going or what you're going to podcast about. And then be as specific as you can. Narrow it down. Telescope it down until you can pinpoint that one thing that you're really, really an expert at, that you have an opinion about. And you may eventually become an expert if you don't start that way, but trust me, it works. But one of the things you have to get over is your fear, and you just have to begin, because you can plan and plan and plan and never have the courage to begin. So my advice is don't procrastinate. Another thing that is essential, you need good equipment, especially a good microphone. You don't have to spend hundreds and thousands of dollars or have a professional studio. You can work towards that. But you don't want to go out and spend all that money, and then and your content is the main thing. If you have terrible content, it doesn't matter how crystal clear your sound is, because sound is very, very important. But your content is even more important. So if you don't have good content, no one's going to listen anyway. You'll just have a nice, shiny studio full of the best equipment. Everything will sound just pristine, but you've really got nothing to say, and you'll have no followers. So don't be fooled by the shiny things in life like that in podcasting. Make sure it starts with content, but on equipment, you should have a good microphone. You don't have to spend a fortune, but like I said, sound is everything. And then you also need a good sound editing equipment, whether you do it analog or if you do it through a computer using different programs on a PC or a Mac or however you do it, on a tablet, however you do your podcast. There's a lot of good apps out there too for that. But you want to do that. You definitely want to have that component taken care of having good equipment. It's essential that you find a good hosting website for your podcast and your RSS feed. Then you got to submit your podcast to iTunes and other mediums, and you definitely want to do that. It helps to have a blog where you can expand from the show, have good show notes on there on your website, or have a link leading to your blog where you have extra content. That's where we do some extra content on the blog periodically. We'll tie in with a couple episodes here and there and all that. But what you need to do is enjoy what you do. Also, you will improve and you'll figure out what works and what doesn't work for you. You want to interact with your community through social media. Twitter is probably one of the best. There are a lot of different ways you can do it and promote your podcast that way. You want to make sure that you have that interaction with your audience. One of the fifth things is in this discussion is, what do I use to podcast? That's me specifically. What do I use? Now, what I use may work for you. Parts of it may work for you, or it may not work for you at all. You may have a simpler way. I may be stuck in the past, or what I have from the past may work, you know, but I'm kind of like, if I find something that's good and it's efficient and it works for me, as long as it's working, I don't see a reason to change, but I'm always looking at what's new and what's coming in different mediums and different ways to record. You have to suit it to what your podcast is and what the element, the feeling of your podcast is. But what do I use to podcast? Well, right now I'm running the PC. I'm using the free version of Audacity, and I've used that since 2008. And Audacity is still free, and it's still awesome because, yes, there are better programs you can pay for that give you all that, but you don't have to spend the money. I get great sound quality because I have a good microphone. I'm using a Yeti microphone. It has like four different kinds of settings. It plugs into my PC directly like it is right now. Or, you know, you can buy the professional version of that that will plug into a mixer if you choose to go that route. Depending how you want to do it, if you want to take callers on your podcast, you can also use Skype. There's different programs. I'm not trying to plug anything here. I'm just trying to tell you just some of the things. And I've used Skype before when we've had interviews of different people on the show here. And something that I find is good is Levelator. I use that, the free version of that. It's essential to leveling out your highs and lows in your recording because you want to have a good level so that you're the listening enjoyment of your podcast by your audience, which will include you if you listen to yourself. You want it to be pleasant to the ear. Nobody likes a very loud commercial on a TV show, and then all of a sudden there is a commercial and the sound just, you know, jumps right up. You know, you want to respect your listeners because you don't want to turn them off by bad sound quality. And Levelator will help you, essentially what it says, level out your highs and lows. Very essential. For hosting of my podcast, I'm thoroughly happy with the services that Libsyn, that they provide. For the beginner, their interface is straightforward, and their payment plans have really good stats on them. Very affordable, too, on a monthly basis, and you know what stats you have. And why do you need stats? Well, you want to have stats because you want to know who's listening and where your audience is listening from. Like, our second biggest audience is France, and we're very big in France. We're very international here at the podcast. Of course, the U.S. is our biggest market, but France, England, places like that. But we've had places like Russia, Scandinavia, just all over the place listening to us, and we're getting new listeners from around the world, and I love it. The more the merrier, and the more interaction with our listeners, the happier I am. So Libsyn is great. It tells me what browser they're using. It tells me how many downloads per day, per month, per episode, et cetera, et cetera. Great for seeing how our podcast has grown, and I can actually look at the numbers, and and they have wonderful graphs on there. So Libsyn kind of does it all for you. Some people, when you get farther on the road, you might want to host your own RSS feed. You may want to do that so you have total control of it. That's fine. You definitely need to submit your podcast to iTunes, and that's what we do here, obviously. Everybody's on iTunes. Even if you can't stand Apple or whatever, you still need to be on iTunes. Even if you don't get a great bunch of downloads from there, it puts you out there, and that's one of the main avenues. But there are so many other ways that you can podcast now besides using iTunes, and there's a lot of good stuff out there. But we're definitely on iTunes there. We've got a Google Plus account. You know, we're on different things also. For my equipment, I told you I used the Yeti microphone, and can't say enough about the good quality of the Yeti microphone there. What are my final thoughts on podcasting and having that passion through podcasting? Well, my final thoughts on that is that podcasting is really your chance to speak your personal points of view on whatever subject you have a passion for in life. The best way is to plan a little. Don't overplan, okay? But make sure you have something to say specifically. Then you got to record it with good equipment. You got to edit it. Editing definitely takes way much longer than it does to record. If you can find shortcuts where you can do all that, edit with good consistency. So that's your post-production. And then you want to post your episodes for the world to listen to enjoy on your websites, iTunes, wherever. And that way people will be able to interact with you. Be very active in social media. Don't spam people to death with everything, but send out relevant tweets. You know, you can schedule tweets. You can do a lot of good things through Twitter. You definitely need to be on Twitter. There are also other avenues, but Twitter is still one of the basic things. We have a Facebook page also for Geek Homeworld. That's something that you ought to have. You know, you want to be in the major avenues. You want to be able to access the highways that most people travel, but you also want to be in some of the areas that are kind of off the beaten path. So thing is, have a passion for what you do. And let us know here at Geek Homeworld on Twitter. You can just message us. Please go to Facebook and like our Geek Homeworld page. We're on Blogger, Geek Homeworld, at blogspot.com. So go on over there, check them out, like our Facebook page. Leave us some thoughts. Listen to us on Libsyn. That's where the podcast is mainly hosted. And we want to interact with you. We follow a lot of things here, and all from a geek perspective. So I'm always excited to when I get to talk to someone who's a fan of the show, or someone that's got a question, or I've got a question for them, and just the wonderful dialogue that goes back and forth and back and forth. And you know, it's just fun to talk about it, to discuss things, to discuss. I love what if scenarios, like what's going to happen in Star Wars Episode 8? What, you know, what's going to happen in the next Deadpool movie? Which, by the way, Deadpool was awesome. And all those what if scenarios, you know, what if this, what if that? And I love to get the feedback and interaction. Building a community will take time. Please don't be discouraged if you start your podcast, you bought the equipment, you kind of know how to do things, but you're not getting a big following. Everybody starts somewhere. Don't expect to jump out of the gate. And even if you do jump out of the gate with big numbers, don't let your numbers rule you. Don't let the amount of Twitter followers that you have or Facebook likes on your page or whatever, don't let that be the determining factor of whether you think you're successful or not. You'll know if it's not working. If you're putting out content and no one's responding, it could be a lack of promotion. You may have to spend a little money to promote your podcast, and that's fine, you know. Work within your budget. Do what works for you, but find the passion that you have. Start small, and you'll get bigger and bigger. And before you know it, you'll look back, and you won't even imagine how you got as far as you got. And it won't take you long to be a success. And you know what? As I said earlier, it's not always about, is this going to be the career for you? This can also be about the passion of it, just loving what you do. Not many people get to do things in life that they really love doing. And I hope that if your passion is podcasting, I hope that you find that passion, and I hope that you're able to enjoy it. And I hope that you'll interact with us and let us know what your journey's like. And I'm always here to answer questions if you have some. And if you want to interact with the show, certainly do. So I'm going to leave you with this last final thought here. You can do it. So what are you waiting for? Thanks for listening to another episode of the Geek Homeworld podcast with your host, Savage Tech Man. You can find us on Libsyn, Google Plus, follow us on Twitter, like us on Facebook, listen to us on iTunes, see us on YouTube, be part of our Mixlr chats. Thank you. See you again on the Geek Homeworld podcast.